Hi, I'm Robert Rose, Curator Emeritus here at Miami Seaquarium, and I'm here with my longtime friend, Tokite, or also known as Lolita. We're here today to hopefully change the story. We really want to change what we've been talking about for so many years here at Miami Seaquarium. Toki and I have actually been together for over 23 years now, and ever since I started here, we've been talking about her release. Well, it's really time to change the subject now and to talk more about the southern resident killer whale population. Before we do that, let me reiterate why we don't feel she's a candidate for release. Number one, she's lived here for over 47 years, a true testament to the love and care that we provided her during that time. The second thing is just that, her age. She's over 50 years old now. She happens to be the oldest living killer whale under human care. The third, and maybe the most important thing, is the disease or pathogens. The possibility for her to be released and to obtain something that she's never been exposed to, or maybe even more importantly than that, to expose the southern resident killer whale to a disease that they have no way to fight. There's been a new call in the last couple of months by groups and an individual that are calling again for her release. Really, they should be ashamed of themselves. They don't care about Lolita. They don't care about her best interests. They don't really care whether she lives or dies. To them, she's nothing more than a vehicle by which they can promote their name, the political agenda, to obtain money, and to gain media attention. Shame on them. The Lumai Nation has even gone as far to say that she's better off dead. I mean, really? Better off dead? Shame on them. What we need to do is come together as a group to really help save the endangered southern resident killer whale population before it's too late. If we can come together with organizations like National Marine Fisheries and really find solutions to the problems that these whales face, the overfishing, the boat traffic, the pollution, then hopefully we can save this endangered group of animals. When I started with her over 20 years ago, there were over 100 southern resident killer whales. Today, those numbers are down into the low 70s. Together, working together, through her, with her as an ambassador, for the conservation and education, we can hopefully find a solution and help recover this endangered species. Thanks for joining me, and we'll see you next time.